What's this? What's good?
Place to actually put the brand out and actually get that brand awareness. So we just kind of like, and it happened quick too, it happened fast. So before you know it, we was already in New York, everybody was here. It was hard, but
signing leases,
yeah, it was hard. But
what's been the most challenging thing to living
under that? The most challenging thing is Champ had it worse than I did, honestly speaking, because, you know, for what, damn near a month and a half almost.
Show your fucking eyes. Show your chipper face.
But, for real, he was here for like damn near 2 months out here by himself. Crazy as it was, we couldn't stay where we really was at. So he was just out here. I was in Maine at the time, doing what I had to do. And dude was out here for damn near like month and a half, 2 months. He was out here. He got here in the end of September, and I didn't get here until it was more towards the beginning of October. I got here at the end of October, like the week before Halloween.
We spent Halloween at what, 420 Fifth Avenue?
Girl Scout building, yeah. It was crazy too. We like, even on Halloween, like, even though the struggle was bad and we was homeless and shit,
we were still
like ourselves at the same time. We never lost our swag, like.
When you say swag,
like
what we still
wearing. Staying privileged, like, you feel me? Like, I'm homeless, I ain't got nowhere to go. I'm wearing motherfucking all white Ultra Boost ripped jeans I left that back before. I wasn't fucking.
Yeah, but yeah, I had mine, back. You know what I'm saying? Got the Louis bag, Nike Crush those on, you know.
Looking fresh.
Computers.
But at the same time, you know. They was never suspecting me. Like, I was going down to Port Authority or like down to the stairs and shit. I go there before it was time for them to ask for the tickets and shit past 1 o'clock. Man, I be down there in a white shirt. Louis Jean Pat, bitch, I'm homeless. I ain't nowhere to go, but I'm on the computer trying to figure that shit out.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? I ain't just
sit around.
That shit out. Nope. You know what I'm saying?
Why Penn Station out of all places?
Not Penn Station, Port Authority.
Why Port Authority?
No, we did at Penn Station too.
Yeah, Penn Station.
We felt like we were literally like, dude, trying to find our way, bro. It was a matter of days. Like, time was winding down. We was just getting ready to move into the apartment, so we still trying to figure it out.
And this is the apartment, right?
Yeah, this is the apartment here right now where we at. Headquarters. You know what I mean? Like that. But, and like, she was just like getting ready to get good. So we was out there on the, out there in the streets and shit, homeless, wandering off. And I think we actually came from somewhere. We actually went to do something. We went out somewhere. And like, it was the end of the night. Everybody we was with went home. They didn't know what we was going through with none of their business kind of thing. So we just kind of wandered off, ended up at Penn Station, and we fell asleep on the tracks. When we fell asleep on the tracks, it was like a cop. He came, like, he was like kicking on Champ, and the other one had the light in my face. It was like, he couldn't even believe we were out there. That's how fresh we was fresh.
Like, yo, we straight up.
We was fresh. Fuck.
He was like, where you guys heading? We ain't had no ticket. We want them to get a, like, book us tonight. So I just remember the last thing I seen on that time clock said Babylon. He said, where you heading? I said, we waiting on the Babylon behind you. He said, y'all on the wrong track. Maybe you gotta go to that side. So we got up and just teenage and out of that
one.
Yep. Straight to PA.
Like right now, I work for Marriott Vacation Club. Nobody in this world know that I got dressed for my interview. Where at, E? Where I got dressed for the interview at?
Right on the corner from that
brother. Like, literally. Like, no, it was on the train platform.
Well, yeah, right on the train platform. Yeah, 34th Street.
Right on the train platform.
Got dressed for that shit right here. Well, I got dressed for
what
my hat.
What
suits
was it? The, like, blue one? Or, like, that nice black one you wear?
I actually had none of those suits.
I wore one of B. Willie's suits.
Aww.
And I wasn't even completely dressed when I got
and
there.
And B. Willie is your roommate, right?
Yeah. And by the time... The roommate, brother, and business partner. By the time we got to the fucking the job, Pablo was downstairs and Pablo, you know, he had to give me a coat so that I could go upstairs and do the interview because I just had a shirt on. But yeah, man.
Shit, I got a dress for my shit. I went to 2 interviews in one day.
Yeah, I remember that.
It was raining. Bullshit, me. It was raining. I got a dress out.
Were you guys, like, still happy during this time? Like, were you
we
still doing
your stuff? We never gave up hope. We were content with it.
We never gave up hope.
We wasn't really, yeah, we would, like, be, like, kind of bad and shit. But I felt like, for me, the hardest part was when I was alone. I was, like, mad delirious and shit. Like,
sleepy, feet like, burning,
feel me?
Bottom of your feet.
My feet red still ain't healed from that, all that shit, bro.
Feet red.
Still fucked up.
Hot chip.
That shit, bro.
You was walking so much?
Walking, standing up for a minute long. But I ran, like, I got here, I didn't have nowhere to go. I went to see my homie at the Yonkers. Train, the car.
That's how KG.
Bronx.
But even then, like, we was able to scrape up some cash. We had some cash, a little bit of bread. And we was, like, getting little Airbnbs here and there, ain't it, right? Little air mattresses, like, $150 a night type shit. Like,
yeah, it's not cheap no more.
You know what I mean? Like, it was bad, but that shit, we was always ourselves, like.
You guys were together, too.
Yeah, that's when shit started getting better. Yeah, that's when shit started getting better.
Like, dog, I was out here fucking going through it. Like, bro, you said hi, you had 3 heads. I mean, you know, you were trying to come up. Because I almost had been robbed at one point. I was,
Flatbush, man.
Yeah, East Flatbush. I was out there trying to pay for, like, a crib for the moment just to, you know, lay low and shit. And... You know what I'm saying? The door, I went up to the stoop or whatever, right? We opened the door, and I forget the name. It was like maybe like a Rachel or just Andrew or something like that. And, like, I seen like a bunch of feet. I come back in the morning whenever she like let me come out or whatever. Man, dude, bro, niggas got her, niggas started spazzing, kid, like calling me all the time and shit. And I'm just like, all right, fuck you. Back on the bus, a whole another hour out. not even an hour, longer than that. Late night, you know, this is like 11 o'clock, 10:30. Went all the way back to Queens, but really got back on the train, came back to the city. Got to the city like 6 in the morning. Just made it work.
That's dedication.
Shit, one day, I ain't get the job yet. Shit, I went to work. I was sleeping right down the street from Pulse, not even thinking that damn, they work with my brother, they gonna know and think me. Like, I'm out there sleeping at the Girl Scout building on that little fucking marble bench or whatever the fuck that is. Uncomfortable
shit. That shit was like a tip repeated compared to motherfucking PA.
I was out of there. Sleep. Then, Gene, missed that man, Gene. But Gene walked up and was like, yo, like, oh, well, you know, because he think I'm my brother, so he's like, yo, what the fuck you doing? Like, what the fuck, they can't sleep here, like,
man, you know, like, nobody knew.
And I'm just looking at him like,
bitch, who are you?
Dude. And then, like, it hit him before it hit me. Then he was like, wait, no, this ain't him. This ain't him, this is twin. He's like, you a twin? He's like, you a twin? And I'm like, yeah. He was like, yo, do that. I'm gonna do that right here. Like, you feel me? Go around the corner. Make sure nobody know your business. Boy, he started giving me the game. And then from there, we met Mr. Green and Mr. Shake and Bake.
Two old heads, man.
Two old heads. And
I've been trying to find them niggas and bump into them niggas.
They help us survive out there. Like, yo, every day.
He's a
sales guy? No, these are like street cleaning dudes. Like,
you know,
little people you see.
Gene was a security guard, though.
Yeah, he was a security guard.
Shake and Bake and Mr. Green, you niggas are street cleaning niggas. But they like, you feel me, like the good kind of people, though. You know what I mean? Like, they ain't know me from a can of paint, bro. Just started talking to me and shit like that day. Nigga asked me, hey, how's your mom? Your mom is good?
Your mom is good?
He's like,
bro, New York.
He goes, you look like you're having a hard time. Talk to me. And you know, see his little other homie walk up, just as old as he is. Nigga walk up, talking about this right into the chicken, big, and he walk up, he like,
you know? And you know what he said, though? What Mr. Green said before, like, the last time I seen Mr. Green?
What?
He said, it's a big city. Don't get lost and don't forget about me.
Aww.
I'm trying to find Mr.
Green. Yep.
Don't get lost and don't forget about me.
It's a big city. That was real shit. And from the time we got here, like, I dealt with all kind of shit. And I not literally, but I say it because, like, it's how I feel. And I feel like New York made me because I found myself here. If that makes sense. But I've been through people trying to mentor me, people trying to pull me into their religion, all kind of shit.
People pulling at you. Taking it to the religion on the streets on a daily basis.
Yeah,
like right outside of work,
everyone's
coming up to us.
Yeah, man. And it was crazy because we out there still trying to talk to girls and shit. We ain't got a pot to piss in and window to throw it out. We still out there trying to talk to girls and shit. It was wild.
Shit. If I'm being real,
but even from the day that I got here, I ain't regret shit.
Shit, you feel me?
You making me good and he losing his job tomorrow, bitch. It's the end of the road. You never know. Shit turned quick here.
That shit happened to me.
Yeah, even when we, like, another thing. Obstacles. We want to talk about obstacles, okay? We had been here four months. We've been here 4 months. All of a sudden, they shut down Pulse for remodeling. Champ was jobless for a whole 6 months. You feel me? We trying to figure it out. I was in fucking Linkage. You can relate.
I was in Linkage.
You can relate.
You know what I mean? So yeah, that shit.
It took you 6 months to get a job.
Oh, it's just that. He
was fucking going on.
Yeah, he was,
you.
You know, he had to save up a good amount of money in those 4 months, and he started wilding. He just started wilding.
But I would have been smarter.
His money was good when he started getting it.
Had I would have been smarter, though, I would have just been, like, 6 months locked in on my business, like, you feel me? But I had just got here, this shit kind of sucked me in, man.
Oh, it sucks you, man.
I ain't got no job, but I got money.
Shit. shit.
Yep, that was, around the time Brian's birthday came around. We took him out to Chadwick's, bought bottles. Wild out.
Stupid shit. But times like that, you gotta experience and make you think about the shit.
Because you really want it.
Exactly.
Yeah. I did the same thing when I first moved here. I went crazy. There's just so much to do. It's just so much fun.
Just like Paul said some real shit to me. He said...
Paul?
Yeah, he said, you won't never find out your destination if you don't dream. Like, you know what I mean? You'll never find it. Like, if you don't dream this shit, if it's not something you dream of doing, you're passionate about it, and it's something you have to do, you'll never get there.
The
you don't got no dreams.
Can't be so focused on the destination, because then you forget your journey.
Yeah, so it all starts with a dream. Just like H.H.H. just said, who's on some Biggie shit? It was all a dream, and then...
It was all a dream. I used to read Brother
Magazine. You just started rolling and rolling and rolling and rolling and rolling and rolling with it. Georgia. And back. Like, Miami. Like... In the rain. And the day we found out we were moving to New York, well, we were in Georgia, actually. But we just got done talking about moving to New York. We really got a phone call from Amanda. Say, boom, we got a position open for you here in New York. When can you come? He really was on the next flight to New York the next week. The next week, he was already in New York handling business. The week after that, he was packing his shit, moving. Fast. And it was that day when he was like, we going to New York. But what I will say is, if I could do it over again, I'd have just come sooner.